Well, stay tuned, you two, and you may want to think twice before you take out cash. Hackers using now tiny skimmers to steal your card numbers and recording your PIN numbers. We've got all the tips you need to know to keep yourself safe at the ATM right next to our world headquarters.
Are we watching a crime, or is that a guest?
When I come home at night, I bolt the door real tight.
Anna, consumers beware. Criminals have a brand new tool to steal your credit card and bank information. Here we go. The updated smaller ATM Skimmer has a computer and a video camera. Once inserted into the ATM, it can skim your personal information in a matter of seconds. Here to talk about this is Robert Siciliano. He is an identity theft expert with McAfee. Robert, you were just showing me this. This is really stunning.
Yeah. So bad guys are creating skimming devices that look like they belong there. Like they are so thin, and they have all kinds of technology built into them that allow the bad guy to remotely access both the video and the PIN code of your card.
Skim to see your identification,
exactly.
See everything. For example, this is a two-tier process. Show it to
Correct.
You.
So right here you have what looks like a skimming device. They fit it over the card slot, and so when you put your card in, it grabs the information off the back of the magnetic strip. This device right here grabs all your personal information, and then what they do next is they put a small device on the face of the ATM. This looks like a mirror, obviously.
Yep.
Now behind this actually is a camera.
Wow.
This camera pulls the information off of your PIN code. So as you're punching in the PIN code, you want to cover up the keypad with your other hand so the bad guys don't get your PIN.
So that's amazing. So no matter where it's a major bank or it's a card store with an ATM in it, one of those independent ones, and you prefer going to the banks, you always say cover it like this, right?
Yeah, you have to cover up the keypad with your other hand so they don't get the information for your PIN code. Otherwise, they will burn all of that data onto a blank ATM card, and
right.
Then right before midnight, pull out the maximum dollar amount for the day and do it again right after midnight.
So, Robert, you were saying before, okay, this looks like there's something odd about this. Even though I would do it and not pick it up, you would. However, if done correctly, these would mold to the way the curvature is, which makes it really hard to predict.
Exactly. The bad guys have the ATM sitting in front of them when they create the actual skimming device. So it molds right to the face of the ATM. It looks like it belongs there. And to the naked eye, most people aren't going to see it. So what you always want to do is kind of fiddle around with the face of the ATM. If you can pull something off, then that means you have a skimmer in your hands.
All right, so you have a skimmer in your hands. And let me give you an idea. Even if you're in a small town or a big town, major city, small city, you're saying this is happening everywhere?
ATM skimming is a $1 billion a year business, and it's affecting consumers all over the U.S. Overseas, they have what's called chip and PIN, which is better card technology that can't easily be compromised. Over here, we have that magnetic strip, and until we get rid of that magnetic strip, consumers are always going to be vulnerable. So what you have to do is pay close attention to your statements. I recommend downloading your bank or credit card company's application on your smartphone and looking at your statements every single day at this point.
Because they don't take out zillions of dollars. They'll do little hits on you, correct?
They
might not detect it.
They'll take out the maximum dollar amount for the day, which is usually $500, like right before midnight. Do it again right after midnight, which is another $500. If they have 20 cards, they can make $20,000 a day.
Wow. Robert Siciliano with McAfee. As you are identity theft expert, unfortunately, we're going to need your expertise more and more.
Thank you.
All right, Robert. Thanks a lot. And I just need $100. All right, I'd rather it from your account, if you don't mind. Hey, Steve and Anna, back to you.
How about $100 out of your account? We need lunch money, Brian.
Mm-hmm.